गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द न्यू चैप्टर। दिस इज चैप्टर नंबर 12, फ्रिक्शन, राइट। एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज फोर्स ऑफ फ्रिक्शन, राइट। इन जनरल फ्रिक्शन एंड फोर्स ऑफ फ्रिक्शन आर सेम। फ्रिक्शन इज ऑल्सो अ फोर्स, दिस इज द अपोजिंग फोर्स। तो आर फर्स्ट टॉपिक विल बी फोर्स ऑफ फ्रिक्शन, राइट। नाउ सी, देयर इज एन ऑब्जेक्ट विच इज पुट ऑन द सरफेस ऑफ अनदर ऑब्जेक्ट। व्हेन वी पुश इट फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट हैंड साइड डायरेक्शन, एन अपोजिंग फोर्स एट द सरफेस इन कॉन्टेक्ट विल कम इन टू प्ले। मीन्स द अपोजिंग फोर्स विल ट्राई to oppose the motion of this body, right? So this opposing force is called force of friction or friction. Now we can define it as force of friction is the force which opposes the motion of the object over a surface. Means the object is facing an opposing force for its motion, right? The force of friction act between the object and the surface of another body. It means the force of friction always apply or applicable at the surface in contact only. This is the surface in contact of two bodies, right? For example, a ball is rolling on the ground, gradually slow down and comes to the rest due to force of friction between the ball and the ground. This is the ball. It is moving in this direction and its speed is slowed down with time, and after some time it gets stopped. It means some opposing force is acting on it, right? In second example, if we stop pedaling a bicycle, it gradually slow down and it comes to stop due to force of friction between wheels and the road, right? Now this is a cyclist. If the cyclist stops pedaling, after that the speed of cycle will slow down and after some time it will get stopped. It means the road surface is acting a force on the cycle wheel in opposite direction. That's why its speed is gradually decreasing and after some time it will get stopped. Okay? It will get stopped. So these are the two examples of force of friction. In first example, ball is rolling on the earth surface and after some time it will get stopped. It means opposing force is working and it is reducing the speed of the ball and after some time it get stopped. In second example, the cyclist stop the pedaling and after some time cycle get stopped. So this is the force of friction. Now factors affecting friction. Factors affecting friction. Now what are the factors which affect the friction, which increase or decrease the friction? Now friction depends on two factors. Number one, nature of the surfaces in contact. First of all, the surface of two bodies which are in contact, that is the factor which affects the friction. The smoothness of the surface. For example, there are two bodies, this rolling body and this surface, right? It is released from this surface, coming down to the earth surface and rolls over this surface and get stopped at this place. In second case, the surface is very rough. This is the rough surface. Now again, the body released from the same sliding surface from the same height, it get stopped within few seconds. Since this is the very rough surface, so roughness of the surfaces will produce the force of friction. Weight will oppose the motion of the body and the body will get stopped, right? Now, the second one, how hard the surfaces pressed together. For example, there is a body which is very heavy. So what it will do? It will press the surface of another body and the roughness of the surfaces will get interlocked. Roughness of the surfaces will get interlocked and it will oppose the motion of the body. It means the opposing force will be very high. So there are two factors in this slide. First one is nature of the surface in contact, means the roughness of the surface, degree of roughness of the both the surfaces. And second one is how hard the surface pressed together, means the heaviness or weight of the body which is sliding, right? For example, there are two bodies. This body is heavier than this body, right? So it will press the surface harder than the second one. It means the force of friction in this case will be higher and the force of friction in this case will be lower. So this is the example of second factor, which is the weight of the body. Higher the weight, higher will be the force of friction, right? Now, cause of friction. In this topic, we are covering what is the cause of friction, right? Friction is caused due to interlocking of irregularities between the two surfaces in contact. For example, there are two bodies, right? This first body and second body. By naked eye, you can see that this surface is very smooth. But with the help of microscope, we find that both the surface have irregularities. Right now, you can see in this diagram, the roughness of the surface of upper body and the roughness of the surface of lower body. And these irregularities will interlock to each other. So these irregularities interlock will oppose the motion of the body. Means the interlocking of the irregularities will apply force in opposite direction and it will try to stop the motion of the two bodies. Means the main cause of the friction is irregularities of the surfaces. Smooth surfaces have minute irregularities between the two surfaces, whereas rough surfaces have large irregularities between the two surfaces. If surface is very rough, it means irregularities are very high. If irregularity is very high, it means there is a large number of interlocking. And if interlocking is very high, it means force of friction is very high. So the force of friction is more if the surfaces are very rough. In the previous slide, we have seen that the roughness of the surfaces in contact is the most affecting factor for the friction. So higher the smoothness of the surfaces, lower will be the friction. And the higher will be the roughness, then the higher will be the force of friction. And if the object having higher weight, it means interlocking of the roughness of the surfaces will be very high. So force of friction will be very high. So from this slide, we can get that every surface has few roughness. If the surface is smooth, it means lower the roughness, and lower the roughness, it means lower the force of friction. The main cause of the force of friction is the interlocking of the roughness of the surface. So this is the cause of friction, right? In the next lecture, we will discuss about the type of friction. friction is necessary means the friction is sometimes useful, friction is sometimes undesirable, and increasing friction, how can we increase the friction and how can we reduce the friction. And the last segment of this chapter we will discuss about the fluid friction, means the friction in gases and liquids, right? So thank you very much.